Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about Power BI release November 2022 as part of Catch Up with Nags series. Without wasting time, let's begin. And this channel contains free content worth $1,000 or 80,000 INR worth. So please utilize this free content, which covers Power BI, MSBI, that includes SSIS, AS, RS, and also it focuses on SQL Server as well. So you can go through all the playlist if you want to learn or get knowledge on each and individual subject area. With this note, let's begin our today's topic. So basically for November 2022, it was released on 29th of November. So it was end of the month, so can't make it before November. So that's why I'm making this video on December first week. So let's see what's interesting in this. We will go one by one, and a few of the things we can skip because it is not widely used by many of the audience. So first thing, it's like unshared and unsynchronous access for small multiple charts. If you are familiar with the small multiples, you can see like this y-axis is common across all the charts over here. And sometimes what happens for some category, you can see there is no data. I mean, it's very less, but still the axis remains same, right? So they come up with turning off the shared axis so that each category has its own axis values. And then you can also say like scale to fit. Two properties you need to set, like unchecking the shared y-axis and then scale to fit. If you choose this, now you can see for this purple in before doing these properties, it is very small. I mean, it matches with the shared axis. Now after doing that, this will have its own axis value so that you can see the actual value pertaining to that category, right? So this is one of the future. I like it. Then it's all about some properties changes like controlling and customizing labels for the Azure Maps. These are some of the things who are interested in Azure Maps. They can go for it. I can skip for it now. And this one, I liked it much. This is very good feature because as you may aware, I have a video for field parameters a few weeks back, so you can check it out, that one. So basically create dynamic slices using field parameters. What it means, one of the issue highlighted is like if you choose the field parameter concept is like you can choose any measure and you can choose any the values here, the categorical value. Like if you want to see product wise cost of goods, then when you click on products and cost of goods, it will show you products each item and then the value. But there is no way you can filter this products, okay, over here. So people raise this concern, when I choose a product or any other categorical filter, they also need to filter some of the items that is displayed here. So that is the thing people requested. Then Microsoft come up with a solution, like just copy paste this the slicer, the dynamic slicer, then you need to set this property like show values of selected field. Then once you choose this property for each categorical item, whatever you choose, those values will be highlighted here. Once you choose product, now you can see these are the products. From here you can uncheck some of the items, so you will see only those products for the category. I mean, dynamic slicer, you can choose either product. In the product, you can filter as well. So this is very good feature. I like that much. Another thing about composite model over Power BI dataset. Earlier, there is no composite model if you use Power BI dataset or analyst service. Now you can have the composite model. That is another good feature. I like it. Then coming, we can skip these things. And this one, I like it. Like evaluate and log. So there is nowhere you can debug your DAX measure like what it is intermediate results. You need to use some external tools, of course. You can write step by step steps and then you can use some external tools to work it out. Now Power BI has given one of the function called evaluate and log, and once you use this one, you can see these results, right? And provided that you should aware of some SQL profiler tool. So once you have this measure, when you launch a report, these queries will be fired, and what is the value of it, you can check. So for that, you can use the profiler. Then there is some new DAX functions, two CSV and two JSON. So if you put these values here to CSV dim product, this will be exported to as a CSV file, as a CSV format actually. So this is another two DAX functions. And apart from that, the feature I like most is this one, new way to upload Power BI and Excel files. Basically, this will solve how people, if multiple people are working in the same report, this will definitely help them to solve the purpose. Basically, what it does is new way to upload the files from OneDrive or SharePoint or Browse. Once you choose these options to upload and one Power BI file, so it will be deployed in the Power BI service. One more thing, what it happened is every 1 hour it will sync. Once you update the Power BI file in this SharePoint, in the or OneDrive, Power BI services will automatically sync. You see this point, Power BI can automatically sync those changes about every hour. So every 1 hour it is scheduled, like you update, you work on some Power BI desktop, you are storing in your desktop file, the data is updated, right? Until you publish it, it won't reflect. Same way, you are doing your report in the Power BI desktop, you upload it in the SharePoint. Whatever changes you do, you sync it in the SharePoint. This sync between SharePoint and the Power BI services now will automatically happen. So this is one of the good future when people, multiple people are working on the file, because once they're done with the job, then they can just upload it and they can sync those changes. So this is very good feature, I like it. So this is one of the thing. And then as I already mentioned, I will come up with metrics is the one, linked metrics. I never seen this feature. I will just have a look at it and then I will create a video on that. One last thing about I like that is like subscribe to your report with filters applied. So you can apply some of the filters, then you can use the subscription. So if you are aware of subscription is something like you will get it in email, the report you subscribe to based on the frequency you choose. So these are the features I like the most. I hope you enjoy this video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.